From the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
Hello, everyone. My name is Betsy Peterson, and I'm the director of the American Folklife Center. And on behalf of the staff, I want to welcome you all here today. This is a homegrown concert, or part of our homegrown concert series, which is an opportunity for the American Folklife Center to present some of the very best traditional music being performed and practiced within the United States and beyond. We work with folk arts coordinators, ethnomusicologists, folklorists from around the country who help us select some of the very best traditional artists to bring here and share their music and art forms with you all. Today's concert, actually, is also co-sponsored by two other library divisions, which I certainly want to mention, the Library's Music Division and the African and Middle Eastern Division. And I know we have the head of the African and Middle Eastern Division, Mary Jane Deeb, here, and welcome. And I also want to take a second to thank our sound crew, who often does not get the recognition that they should. And so I just want to mention Mike Turpin, Jake Kinlock, and John Gold, and our colleagues from ITS for taping today's concert. And with that caveat, we do tape our concerts, all of our concerts, in part, so we can put them up on the website. Soon after, these are archived and become part of the American Folklife Center archive, but also are shared on the internet so that people throughout the world and in generations beyond can hear this great music today. So if you have any electronic devices, cell phones, et cetera, on, if you could turn them off right now, we would appreciate it. Today we have a very rare opportunity to present two enormously talented and extremely accomplished Syrian musicians. Lubana Al Quntar, who now lives in Virginia, comes from a Syrian family that is deeply rooted in traditional Arabic music. And in addition to traditional Arabic song, Lubana also has studied opera and became the first Syrian opera singer to attain international recognition, as she has appeared in concerts throughout Europe. She returned to Syria and headed the Department of Opera Singing and launched the Department of Classical Arabic Singing at the Syrian National Conservatory. This was a very groundbreaking event because for the first time, students could study both operatic and traditional singing at an accredited institution in one and the same place. She also established the Arabic Music Singing Ensemble that performed across the Middle East. She will be accompanied today by Kenan Adnawi, who joined the High Music Institute in Damascus, Syria in 2003, where he studied the oud with Azerbaijani expert Askar Ali Akbar and graduated in 2008. Adnawi has since performed in Morocco, the United Arab Emirates, Austria, Lebanon, and has toured with the Qatar Philharmonic, performing in the US. In 2009, he won first place in the International Oud Competition in Beirut, Lebanon, and Kenan is currently enrolled, luckily for us, in an MA program in contemporary music at the New England Conservatory. So please, let's give a warm welcome to Lubana Al Quntar and Kenan Adnawi.
Thank you. Thank you. من سيوف ما Being here. The song that I just sang is it's called Muwashah, which is a form which is very important in our traditional music in all region, I mean the Arab region, not just Syria. And its importance because of, you know, the poem, because of the rhythm, and because the way of singing that it require ability to for this the articulation in each part of the music. This song called Ya Ashiqat Al Wardi, the flower, for the flower lover. It's the composer is Lebanese. His name is Zeki Nassif, and he's very important because of his way of writing. It reform. Or the traditional songs. It makes it more more popular. excuse my English, well, I'm trying. Okay.
يا عاشقة الوردي
على وادي فحبيبك منتظر يا عاشقة الورد.
Hello.
I always, in this kind of concert, which you know, the people apparently doesn't relate too much to the word and to the language, and it's kind of strange. I always like to sing this song, which is it's a combination between opera and Arabic, and its name is Ya Tuyur, and I will sing it a cappella. And it's written about in the 50s with an Egyptian, very famous composer. His name is Muhammad Al-Qasabji.
غني حبي وانشدي واجدي وامالي للي جنبي واللي شايف ما جرالي اشتكي له يبتسم ويزيد له Oh, نسيم يسري علي يحمل الصوت
Apparently, it's about singing about the birds, how it's, you know, has beautiful voices and. Okay. Yeah. This song is also a very traditional Damascene song called "هل أسمر اللون." It's about the brunette guy. Okay.
هل أسمر اللون
Maybe most of you doesn't know that I'm an opera singer professionally, so I'm gonna present one opera song, very famous, from Puccini. To change completely the sad atmosphere. for a much sad atmosphere, which is, Loretta is, also crying for her love.
Thank you. And please thank Lubana Al Quntar and Kenan Adnawi. Thank you all for coming today. We really appreciate it. It's very rare to have a singer who's so expertly schooled in two very, very awesome, yes, traditions, is that what you said, of singing. Anyway, thank you very much. Please join us. If you'd like to talk to them about getting a hold of their music, you can come on up after the concert. And please join us in April 15th. We will have Sherman Holmes from the Holmes Brothers, along with their apprentice, the Holmes Brothers' apprentice, Brooks Long, and Phil Wiggins on harmonica, doing a gospel blues concert. So please join us April 15th. Anyway, thank you again for coming today.
This has been a presentation of the Library of Congress. Visit us at loc.gov.